Hello there, I am Jessica from UPDF, and today I am back with another step-by-step tutorial on how to use UPDF. We are going to be diving into the annotation tool, so how you can annotate your PDFs. And before we dive in, click on the link in the description below so you can download UPDF and you can follow along the step-by-step tutorial whilst you are using UPDF. So, how do we annotate using UPDF? I'm going to give you a step-by-step guide.
First of all, open UPDF on your computer and open up your PDF of choice. On the left-hand side, you will see a panel which includes the comment icon, which will reveal the suite of annotation tools along the top. So we have sticky notes that you can place anywhere in your document. We have the highlight tool, strikethrough, underline, then a squiggly line. We also have text comment, text box, and text callout. And we have a pencil and an eraser so you can draw across your document. You can also add shapes to your document, nice stickers to make it nice and colourful and less boring, and stamps to do the same thing, and of course you can add your signature.
This is a brief overview of UPDF's annotation tools, but it's not enough to just know them. Let's dive in a little bit into more detail and I'll show you step by step on how to use each of the tools. Imagine as a teacher you're grading a student's work, or maybe you have an employee and you want to make a comment on their work. That's when UPDF's commenting features come in really useful.
With UPDF, there are different ways to add comments to your document. We have text comment, text box, and text callout. And if you prefer sticky notes, we also have the option to add sticky notes to your document. To add a text comment, just click on the text comment box at the top, and you can just click anywhere to add your text comment. You can also change the color, the font, and the size of the text that you've put onto the document. You can also click on the text and drag it around your document to move where it is, and you can also drag the box to make it bigger or smaller. If you prefer using sticky notes to leave comments, press on the first icon and you can change the color of the sticky note and just select somewhere on the document so you can place your sticky note and start writing. You can also change the color when you're in edit mode for the sticky note, and then you can drag it around the document to relocate it, and you can also choose to copy, delete, or to edit the note. Next, we have the text box, which is also fully customizable. You can drag to make your text box. You can edit the text color, the border color, and even the background color. And again, you can edit the font and the font size. The last option for adding comments is text callout. You just click on the icon, select where you want to put it, and again, you have all of the customization options for making it truly unique. Once you type your comment, you just click outside of the box in order to save it.
While reading a PDF, you must have felt the need to mark up your document in some way. A new PDF provides features that allow you to highlight, strike through, underline, and more.
To use any of these markup tools, just click on the comment icon, select the tool, and then draw over the text. The text will be marked in the way that you want. All the properties and methods of using highlight, underline, strike through, and squiggly are the same, so here I will take the highlight feature as an example. When you select the highlight tool, you can change the color of the highlight before you select the text. Then just draw over the text that you want to highlight, and there you go. You can click on the highlighted content to get options such as copy text, clear, you can add a note to the highlighted text, strike through, underline, and squiggly, and you can also change the color of the highlighted text. In general, most of us will want to use these settings and these tools more than once. So once you have selected the specific settings, such as the color for the highlight, you can then double click on the highlight button at the top and it will save your settings and you can continue to highlight as many phrases and words as you like. To recall the effect, like highlighting the text continuously, just simply click once on the icon again to remove the effect.
Drawing in PDFs is also a very popular requirement. A new PDF allows you to use a pencil and an eraser function so you can draw on your PDFs in real time and you can also erase whatever you have drawn or written.
Again, in the top toolbar, you can select the pencil option where you can change the color, the thickness, and the opacity of the drawing lines. Once you have customized your settings, just choose somewhere on the document and you can start drawing away using the settings you chose for your pencil. If you decided you made a mistake, you can click on the eraser tool to erase what you drew, but there is also an option to select partial erasing where you can decide what's erased, or you can erase the whole drawing that you just created. To use the effect continuously to draw, remember to double-click on the icon and you can draw freely for as long as you want. UPDF also has an extensive range of shapes that you can add to your files, such as rectangles, ovals, lines, polygons, and more. Once you are happy with the chosen thickness and opacity of your shape, just click somewhere in the document to add your shape. If you click on the shape, you will get options to copy the shape, to delete it, to add a note to the shape, or to even change the properties of the shape, such as the opacity, color, or thickness.
You might also want to attach files to your PDF, and with UPDF, you can easily attach files to help your reader to understand your project or your document more clearly.
Click on the Attach File icon and choose the type of file that you would like to attach. You can also choose the color of the icon of the file and again the opacity. Click on anywhere on the file to insert your new attachment and select your file that you would like to add in, and then it will be embedded into your document in the form of an icon. If you double click on the icon, it will then open your new attachment. If you click on the file just once, you will get options to open, to save, to copy, delete, add a note to the file, and even the opportunity again to change the properties.
Next up, we have the sticker tool. So UPDF features a wide variety of cute and cool stickers, which can help you to brighten up your PDF documents.
To add stickers, click on the sticker icon in the top toolbar, select the sticker that you want to use, and select a place on the document of where you want to place it. If you click on the sticker, you can then drag the arrows to resize it very easily, and you can drag it along the document to relocate it.
Just like the stickers, UPDF also has an extensive range of stamps, and if you're not happy with the selection of stamps, then you can also personalize your own ones and add them in.
To add stamps to your PDF, click on the stamp icon in the top panel and select a stamp of your choice and select where to place it in your document. If you click on the stamp, you can drag it around the document and you can also resize it as you wish. If you couldn't find the type of stamp that you need, you can actually create your own stamp. You can write in it exactly what you want, you can change the shape, and then once you've created your stamp, you just select where you want to place it and it will be placed directly into your PDF.
And finally, we have left the best feature till last, which is the signature tool. UPDF allows its users to maintain security and integrity of documents by adding freehand signatures to any PDF documents. This means that your PDFs have authenticity and it is easy to add your signatures in just one click. This is very useful for signing PDF documents from anywhere at any time.
It is super easy to add a signature to a PDF using UPDF. All you have to do is click on the signature button, and if you don't already have a signature created, you just use the freehand tool to draw your signature. Once you have your signature, just drag it to the location in the document, and you can easily resize it and move it around to the correct position.
And that's it, everyone. We hope this video was useful for you. We have given you a comprehensive guide on all of the annotation tools that UPDF has to offer, and we have dived into detail step by step on how to use each of the tools. If you found this video useful, please give the video a like, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more useful guides in the future. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.